Hi everybody, Anastasia from Explain Everything here, and I'm really glad that all of you could join me today. I hope that you can see me and hear me properly, and today what I'm going to do is I'm going to be walking you through all of the basics of how to use our software. So as you know from the title of this training webinar, this is all about, you know, all about the beginners. Today I'm going to be walking you through all of the absolute basics that you need to get started using Explain Everything. Well, today and Thursday, actually, because today I'm going to be walking you through the tools mostly, because as you can see here, we certainly do have a wide range of tools. So I'm going to be walking you through all of these different ones so that you know what you have at your disposal when creating a project. And then on Thursday, as you probably know, same time, same place, I'm going to be walking you through how to share your creations. Because as you might know, Explain Everything allows you to share your projects several different ways. It allows people to collaborate on projects in real time. It allows you to really take your presentations up a notch by making them, you know, interactive, etc. But like I said, that's what we'll get to on Thursday once we get through the absolute basics, which is what we are going to talk about right now, the tools. So if everyone can see me and hear me properly, I'm getting some confirmation that that is the case, then I think I'm just going to start with a detailed demonstration of, as I said, what we have right here in this toolbar so that you can create your own beautiful, interesting projects, and then later share them with your students. So let's start by taking a look at this project that I've prepared right here for this exact purpose, this project on heart anatomy. And what we're going to do is we're going to start by just talking a little bit about the first tool right here, which is the hand tool. So the hand tool is the default tool in Explain Everything. When you open an Explain Everything project, the first tool that's usually selected is the hand tool. And the hand tool is aptly named because it works much like your hand would if you were actually touching, you know, physical objects. So basically, you can use the hand tool, as you can see here, to just, you know, touch and drag things around the canvas. Anybody who has a smartphone or an iPhone, and you know, who doesn't these days, knows how this works. It's pretty much the same idea as it would be if you were touching the screen of your smartphone, iPhone, etc. Of course, you can not only drag things from one side of the canvas, we call it the canvas, to the other, but you can also use this pinch gesture to make things bigger, to make things smaller. Once again, this is something that you're probably all familiar with when you use your smartphone. So if I just do something like this, you'll notice it gets bigger. And if I do something like this, it gets smaller. That's pretty obvious. One thing that I think is a little bit of a hack that you might not guess and that could come in handy, in super handy, is that double tapping straightens things. So, you know, sometimes, you know, you want it to be exactly straight and you're, you know, slowly trying to move it, trying to get it right. With Explain Everything, you don't have to do that. The hand tool allows you to do it with a double tap. So let me just show you how that works. I'm going to maybe take this, the sign here where it says heart anatomy, and it's a little, you know, off to the side now. And what we're going to do is double tap it like this. And what's happened, whoops, it went a little higher up, but what's happened is it has now straightened. So once again, crooked and straight. Now it keeps moving up a little bit higher, but as you can see, it is now exactly straight. So basically, that's the hand tool. There are other ways that it can be used, but this is just Explain Everything for beginners. So those are the most basic uses. Drag and drop, resize things, and double tap to straighten. Now, let's move on to the pen tool because, you know, Explain Everything is, after all, a digital whiteboard. And what would a digital whiteboard or any whiteboard be without the ability to write on it? So let's go to the pen tool, which is right here. And as you can see, when I tap the pen tool, this little menu comes up. And this menu allows us to do a few different things, and I'm going to show you the most important ones right now. So the first thing I wanted to mention is stroke thickness, because you might want a really, really thin, tiny little stroke like the one right here, or you might want something a lot bigger and more visible, depending on your project, depending on your needs. We're going to choose one that's kind of medium, so maybe I'll go with this one right here. And then if you tap the pen, as you can see here, you can choose a pen, a pencil, or a ruler. If you choose a pencil, you get to choose what kind of pencil, if you want to like shade things in. We have some users who do beautiful, beautiful, intricate drawings using the pencil, and this allows you to use the kind of pencil that you prefer. And the ruler, which I'm not going to get into right now, we'll do that in the more advanced level, which is also coming up, by the way, so stay tuned. But let's go back to the pen for a second. I think I'll stick with the pen. And now let's go to colors. So there are a few colors here that our graphic designer used to produce this project. These are the colors that she used, but what if I wanted to use something else? So if you tap a color, what also pops up is our default, like the explain everything default color menu. So as you can see, we have kind of like this soft orangish red here, yellow, this kind of like sea green, and etc. But what if you want more than that? No problem. All you have to do is tap the plus, and as you can see, what comes up here is all of the colors of the rainbow. So anywhere that you know, that you stop, as you can see, we have this little box here where the colors are changing. Anytime you see something you like, stop there, and that's the color you're going to get to use. Also, if your institution uses really, really specific colors that you'd like to use in your project, they're like your school's, you know, colors. So what you can do is tap the number sign here and use hex codes to get the exact color that you want. So if that's the case, as you can see here, this color has, this color's number is, one second, let me just go back there for one second. This color's number, or code, I'm sorry, is A2F0BA. So if that's how specific you need to get, no problem, explain everything lets you do that as well. So let's take a look right here, right now. Let's say that, for example, I want to pick red, and I want to circle a few different things using my pen tool. You can also use your finger, your stylus. If you're using the web app, so if you're like, you know, on your desktop or laptop, you can also use the mouse to do this, no problem. And you can just circle certain things. It's as easy as using a pen on a real piece of paper. And to kind of back up that point, I also wanted to just quickly mention that one of the cool things about drawing and explain everything is that what you draw sticks to what's underneath it, because sometimes when you're using different apps, maybe you've noticed that you can draw like a circle or something, right? But then when you move the image, the circle stays there kind of awkwardly by itself while the paper that was under it moves. Not in explain everything, if you go to the hand tool and then move the paper, as you can see, the circles that I drew here stay exactly where they're supposed to be. It's a little thing, but it is incredibly, incredibly, convenient and useful. So that's the pen tool. Now let's move on a little bit to the highlighter, because maybe you're not looking for such a, like, you know, dark, thick stroke. Maybe you're looking for something a little bit more subtle. So that's where the highlighter comes in. So once again, when you tap the tool, just like with the pen tool, you get this little menu. So of course, stroke thickness. I think this time we're gonna go for something bigger, you know, to really highlight some stuff. And then if you tap any one of the colors, what happens is this menu comes up again. I think I want to highlight using green this time, this sea green right here. So I'm just going to tap that. And now what I can do, as you can see, is highlight anything that I need to highlight using this color. If at any time I want to change the color, just go back to the menu, tap the color again, pick a different one. Maybe I'll go with, what do I want? This one this time, and continue highlighting. So it's basically as if you were holding like one of those old, feather pens made from feathers in your hand and just dipping it into whatever ink you want, whatever color ink you want, and then using that ink to illustrate or to annotate or to draw something. So it really is as simple as that. But say, for instance, you made a mistake. Everyone makes mistakes. It happens. No big deal. What do you need? You need an eraser, probably. So let's take a look, because that's the next tool right here on our list, is the eraser. As you can see, we have three different erasers in Explain Everything. I'm going to talk about the first one and probably the second one as well. So basically, the first eraser erases things that you just wrote down recently. So as you can see, it doesn't work right here because I did this a few minutes ago. Also, let's pick a bigger eraser. So as you can see, it doesn't work on this, but it does work on my most recent illustrations or my most recent, doodles or additions to drawn additions to the canvas. So if I wanted to erase that, that's how you would do that. If you need an eraser that goes a little bit further, you could say, then just choose the second one. And the second one cuts through more levels of the project, right? More layers, I'm sorry, more layers of the project, like this right here. But be careful with it because it can also take out parts of the project. As you can see, it is kind of cutting through a little bit of this lovely heart illustration that we had here. So usually people use the first eraser and the second one if you really want to erase more, deeper, you could say, because the project is made of different layers. So that's the eraser. Then we're going to talk about the bucket fill tool. Anyone who's used, I don't know, Microsoft Paint in their lives is familiar with the bucket fill tool. I'm not going to get too much into it. The most important thing when using the bucket fill tool is to make sure that the figure that you're trying to fill is closed, because if it's open, you'll end up spilling that, that bucket of paint all over everything, and that's probably not what you want. So say, for instance, I want to, maybe I'll just use this soft yellow right here and use the bucket fill tool. And when I tap, oops, I accidentally touched a letter. When I tap this little box right here, it will turn yellow using the bucket fill tool. Okay, next let's move on to some simple figures. So let's take a look right here. This is pretty self-explanatory. We have a little square, a little circle. So say, for instance, you need to draw a figure, like a super, symmetrical figure. You don't just want to sketch one out, no problem. All you have to do is tap, for example, this right here. And for example, say we want to draw, I don't know, a square. Yeah? And maybe we'll change the color of the square to this color. So we have the square selected, we have the color selected. Now all you have to do is tap and hold until you draw the shape that you want. As you can see, this little dotted line appears when we are drawing, we could say, like a perfect square. So if that's what you need, like something that's, exactly as tall as it is wide, or exactly as high as it is wide, then you wait for that line to appear and let go. And when you do that, what happens is you have a perfect square. Of course, if you wanted a rectangle, then you can just drag it a little bit more, drag it out a little bit more, and now you have a rectangle that you could, for example, write something on, or I don't know, you could build a little house out of it. The sky's the limit. Your imagination is the limit. When it comes to writing things, we also have sticky notes, so I'm going to get to that in just one second as well. But say, for instance, you want a circle, so you can just, or maybe let's go with an arrow, for example. Yeah, we want an arrow, but we want the arrow to be like a more, a stronger color to kind of really get people's attention on what we on what it is that we want to talk about. So I have this red, super bright red color selected. I have the arrow selected, and once again, what you have to do is tap and hold, and this arrow appears wherever you've tapped and held. If you want to move it, use the hand tool, and you can move it around your canvas. all of the elements that you draw, that you create, can be moved around the canvas. And if you want it to be bigger, again, the hand tool, use two fingers, whoops, just like I am here. And this arrow could be this big if that's what we wanted. However, maybe we'll shrink it back down a bit because that's a bit overwhelming, and change the direction, put it right here so it points to the septum, okay? So that's that. We have different figures. We also have a few other figures, you know, in the making. We recently got a request from a math teacher for a trapeze and a few other figures. So we're definitely getting to that. I'm sorry, a trapezoid. And we're definitely getting to that. All right, so we kind of know how to draw now, right? We kind of know how to, circle things. But what if we wanted to type something, right? We didn't want to like write it out because maybe we have bad handwriting, or maybe we just don't want to take up that much room. Typing is super practical. So if you tap the little letter A right here and then tap anywhere on the canvas, what appears is a text box. And this text box can be typed in. Also notice that this menu showed up here at the bottom of your screen. And this means that you can choose the font. So we have quite a few different fonts to choose from. You can also change the size of whatever it is that you want to write. So the font size, so maybe we'll go with something a little bit bigger. Also you can choose, the orientation of the text, if you want it left, right, center, it's up to you. And of course you can bold things, put them in italics, underline them, or do none of the above. It's again completely up to you. Importantly, we have to choose the color of the text, because if we write blue text on a blue background, obviously it will be quite invisible. So let's take a look right here. And let's say that we want to write the date of today's lesson on heart anatomy. So that would be the 26th of October, 2021. And once again, whatever we write as an element that is now on the canvas can be moved and resized once you switch to the hand tool, as you can see here. So I could just put this off to the side here if I wanted to just share this project with my students later, and for them to know what the day was that this lesson took place. So that's that. I wanted to move on to something right now that is very useful for, if, for example, if you wanted to duplicate your illustration, right? Of course, you can copy and paste, but you can also use the cutout tool, which is something that we have right here. And the cutout tool allows you to basically either cut something out that's square or rectangular, but that's not always what we want to do. Let me show you how that works. I could do this, and now I have two of these. But as you probably notice, right here, it's visible. This element is rectangular, and we don't always want it to be rectangular. Sometimes we want to be, we want to trace around something. So let me just get rid of that. And I'll show you the one that I prefer to use, which is this dotted squiggly, if you will, line right here. So when you use that, you can trace around an element that you want that doesn't have to be square, for example. As long as you close it, what happens is you now have two of those, right? Like I said, the key is, of course, to close your illustration, because if it's just a line, then, and it's kind of like open, then that won't work. You have to close it, right? And then what happens is it duplicates whatever was in the middle. So if you had, several students working together and you wanted to give each of them, a heart picture like this to label or to work on, then that would make your life really, really easy. And since we're kind of in a chaotic place here on our canvas right now, maybe let's work on getting rid of a few items, because maybe you made a mistake, or maybe you just don't need something on the canvas anymore. And that's where deleting items comes in. So let's take a look at this neat little icon right here, the X. And as you probably have guessed, the X is for deleting things from your canvas. So once this X is selected, all you have to do is tap the element that you want to get rid of, and then tap the little X in the top right-hand corner, and that deletes it from our canvas as you see. You can also highlight more than one object at the same time, for example, this and this, these two little boxes, and then tap the X and they are both gone. So yeah, that definitely comes in handy if, as I said, your canvas got a little bit chaotic or you just added something by accident. The next thing I'm going to talk to you about is the laser pointer, which you probably noticed I already used in a rather humorous form. We got a suggestion back a few years ago, from a user of ours who was like 5, and this kid was like, you know what would be really cool? If we had a laser pointer that looked like a lightsaber. And we were like, you're right. So we have 3 lightsabers to choose from. Also, basically more traditional forms of the laser pointer, so your little arrows, your little hands, the red dot, if that's what you prefer. As you can imagine, this comes in very handy during presentations. So that's the laser pointer. All you have to do is select it, then select the form that you would like, for example, this green arrow. And then when you tap and hold, as I'm doing right now, the arrow appears on your canvas and you can point to exactly what you want to discuss. So that's that. The inspector tool is something that we are going to talk about. It's this tool right here, for the record. As you can see, there's a lot of different options here. Arrange, edit, lock. So there are 3 categories of options and each one of them has, you know, a whole bunch altogether. It's something around 30. We're gonna get to that in just 1 second. I'm going to use a different project for that demonstration. So let's skip that for now. And also, let's go to this tool right here. Maybe I'll use the laser pointer, or no, I'll use this. This tool right here, which allows you to go back. So again, if you made a mistake, if you added something to the canvas that you don't want to be there, all you have to do is tap this icon and it will basically take back what you, the last action you took on the canvas, and you can go back as many times as you need. So once, 10 times, it's really up to you. Let me just show you how that works real quick. So say for instance, we add, I don't know, this red star to the canvas like this, but then we decide we don't want it. And what we could do, instead of erasing it, you know, that takes time, is just tap back and it's gone. So that's that. If we decided that we in fact do want it back, then we can also tap this other little arrow, which basically takes back what you just, the action that you just did. So we can do that if we need, if we like. Okay, so as far as the tools go, that's pretty much what I wanted to show you. Before we move on to the inspector, one other thing that we definitely need to talk about is the add media button. The add media button is right here, and this is what will really allow your project to, you know, to become engaging and eye-catching, because, you know, you can draw, of course, on your canvas if you like to draw, if you're talented, if you're in the mood, but you know, not everybody's very talented, and that means that we can all use a little bit of help illustrating what we want to say on our canvas. And as you can see, there are tons of different options here. So what I could do, maybe, what should I do first? Maybe I'll show you how to add a live browser to your canvas, because that's something that a lot of people don't really even believe is possible the first time we mention it to them. It just seems kind of like too Inception-like to be real, but it's real. All you have to do is tap the browser icon, and this browser pops up that you can then use any way that you want. You can research, I don't know, let's see. Okay. All right, Google is playing tricks on me right now. I will just agree to that. And as you can see, this live browser is now in our canvas, on our canvas, and we can scroll through it. if we need a little bit of extra information, if our student asks us a question we can't quite answer, or whatever the case may be. We add it to our canvas. And then what we can do is, again, using this pinching gesture, we can resize it, shrink it down, blow it up, whatever we need, or just move it off to the side right here to be used again later on. And of course, double tap straightens, as I mentioned before. So that's adding a live browser. Let's go back to the add media icon and see what else we can do here. So what you can do is you can also scan the pages of a book. So if you tap scan, this triggers your device's camera. And what you would do is you would put the page of a book directly underneath and take a scan of that and add it to your canvas. Of course, you could also just use the regular, you know, your regular camera, which can also be triggered by tapping, for example, picture right here. Everybody's gonna get a good look at my headphones because that's what happens to be on the other side of my screen. However, if I tap these arrows right here, that triggers my selfie camera and I can take a selfie for my students. Tap use photo, done, and add it to my canvas. Once again, using my two fingers to resize this image and move it around the canvas anywhere I'd like. If I decide that I want something that's a little bit livelier than just a still photo, no problem. Let me get rid of that. Tap add media and then tap video. And what this does is it triggers your, you know, your camera. It turns your camera on. Of course, we could tap this button right here and turn the camera around. But once again, that would just give my students a view of my table. Not very exciting. Unless you're in the park or something and you want to show them the park, you could do that. But because there's nothing interesting on the other side of my screen, I will leave it in selfie mode. And this way, if I was, say, for example, recording an explainer video for my students, something that we are going to learn to do on Thursday, so 2 days from now, they would be able to see me as I do it. And I think we can all agree that we are all kind of missing, you know, physical, you know, just being able to look people in the face, you know, eye contact, and being able to see your teacher explain as they do it is, I think, better than just listening to their voice. So if that's something that you would like to do, explain everything makes it super easy for your students to see you as you explain things to them as well. I'm just going to remove that real quick. Then the add media icon, of course, allows us to add audio to our project. So all we have to do is this. And then we would tap record, and basically anything that we say would become a part of our project. So if you have, say, for instance, this illustration right here that we have of the heart, and you wanted to do a voiceover for your students, you could simply do it that way and then play it back. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear it because my iPad is connected to my MacBook right now, but let's see. Oh, no, unfortunately, because I'm, you know, hooked up to YouTube doing this webinar, it's not available. The audio is not available right now, but you could add audio that way, no problem. But let's get back to the other stuff that you can do using the add media icon, because there is a lot of it. So, for example, add existing image slash video. So when I tap that, I get access to my entire, you know, photo library, and I can add anything I want to the canvas. I can add files. So say, for instance, I want to add, I don't know, book pages or a presentation. I can add files from my device. I have several different books here, for example. If I wanted to add, what should I add to my canvas? For example, this anatomy and physiology book is a fantastic fit. So say, for instance, I wanted to add just one page. I could tap deselect all and then tap, for example, this specific page right here, and then tap insert. And this would add this very detailed page to my canvas as well. Notice that there are many different file locations that you can add files from. So it's not just your device. Basically, any app that you're, you know, that you're connected to, that you're integrated with, will be available when it comes to adding files. So it can be Dropbox. In my case, it would be Dropbox, OneDrive, you know, Evernote, even Slack, just whatever apps you have on your device, as I said, that are, you know, that are apps that you use. Are ones that you can use to take files from. So the storage options are pretty much endless. Let's go back to the main add media icon menu. Now let's get to something fun that I happen to like very much, which are sticky notes. So when you tap add media and then sticky note, as you can see, a sticky note appears on your canvas. And let's write something on it, shall we? Let's see. Say, for instance, the assignment was for students to list things that are good for your heart, like foods that are good for your heart. So let's write down, for example, nuts, avocados. Let's see, nuts, avocados. What else is good for your heart? Tomatoes, I think. Oops. Okay, and then once we tap the hand tool, move your sticky note around just like this. Again, make it bigger, make it smaller using those gestures we talked about before, and put it anywhere you like. Of course, this would be great for assignments where everybody has to, you know, collaborative assignments where everybody has to add their own 2 cents to the canvas. So, I don't know, each student could have their own sticky note color because, as you will note, there are many colors to choose from right here. You can also add your own custom color if you felt so inclined. But yeah, every student could have their own custom color. And what you could do is have everybody add their own input to the canvas using their own custom color sticky notes. So yeah, I think we've had a lot of great feedback on these sticky notes. People find them fun. And I mean, who doesn't like sticky notes, digital or not, right? So that's that. I'm just going to maybe get rid of these two from my canvas because things are getting a bit crowded around here. Going back to the add media icon because we're not quite done yet. Let's go to clip art. Because as I mentioned, clip art, I mean, not everybody is a fantastic artist, and clip art can be super useful in that area. So say, for instance, we want to add, I don't know, what do we have here? Maybe something, maybe a person. People can be kind of tricky to draw. So say, for instance, we wanted to add a person to our canvas. What we could do is go to the proper category in the clip art library, and then simply select this gardener right here. We're talking about nuts, avocados, tomatoes. This lady knows, like, it looks like she knows a lot about all of those things. And again, we can use the hand tool to resize her and put her wherever we need her to be. So maybe we can just put her right here next to those different garden items that we talked about. Okay, and we're still not done with the add media icon. Let's talk about adding an image from the web. Maybe not GIFs because that's not, like, you know, a super necessary thing right now. Also, you can create your own GIFs. We will get to that in part two. But yeah, let's talk about adding images from the web because anybody who has tried to use, you know, any kind of images from the web knows that it's tricky, right? Like, you don't want to violate a copyright and you don't want to have watermarks splashed all over the place. It can be, you know, it can be annoying. So we are very happy to say that Explain Everything is integrated with Unsplash. And what Unsplash does is it gives Explain Everything users access to over 1 million images that are, you know, copyright and royalty free. You get to use them in your project however you like. So let's see. We talked about avocados. So maybe let's just type avocado in here and tap enter. And as you can see, a whole bunch of pictures pop up and we can, use whichever one we want. So this one is cute. Definitely the more avocados, the better. And once again, using the hand tool, we can resize and straighten and put this right here next to our gardener lady. So that integration really comes in handy. You can find pictures of virtually anything you can think of, and you don't have to search the web for them and get all frustrated, as I said, with watermarks and copyright issues and et cetera, et cetera. Okay, and I think that's pretty much all I wanted to cover when it comes to the add media icon. We have about 10 minutes left in this demo. So the last thing I wanted to talk about is the inspector tool. Remember the inspector tool? I said that it has about 30 functionalities. So what I'm going to do to demonstrate how it works, I think better, is I'm going to exit this project and I'm going to open another project that I prepared that I think will better exemplify how the inspector tool can come in handy. So this is something that a lot of people would go cross-eyed just looking at. These are derivatives, so this is more complex mathematics. And the reason that I decided to use this example is, say for instance, you wanted to, I don't know, move one of these equations around, right? For example, let's see. For example, you wanted to move one of these equations, but you accidentally grabbed only one element, like this one right here. What could happen when you have so much, complex information in one place is you can easily misplace this, and then it ends up here, and then whoever is checking it or whoever is using these notes to learn will come back and say, wait, what? Like, this doesn't belong here. How did this get here? So when you have a lot of elements on your canvas at the same time, when you move one thing or two things, suddenly everything can get very chaotic and disorganized, and it can be hard to tell what's what and what was supposed to be with what in the first place. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to put this right back to where it originally was, which was right here. And I'm going to use the inspector tool to show you how you would move whole parts of this equation together as opposed to accidentally just moving one and creating a bit of a mess. So let's go to the inspector tool right here. And what we're going to do is we are going to select the items that we're interested in. So these and all of these right here, you can see how many little pieces came together to create this one big, this one big problem. And we are going to tap group. And you can kind of see everything kind of move together in that one moment when we tapped group. And so what happened here and why does it matter? So what happened is that now when I select the hand tool and I move this same piece, as you can see, all of these elements move together. So we don't have to worry about things getting, disattached and mixed up and, confusing. So definitely group, the group functionality of the inspector tool will come in super handy for you when you don't want to have to piece together a puzzle of seemingly random elements after having moved them, because that's time consuming and as I said, confusing. So nobody wants to do that. Say for instance, you decide that you actually want to ungroup, right? You want to separate the different parts of this equation. Once again, we would go to the inspector tool, highlight the elements that we are interested in, and tap ungroup. And once again, you can see everything that was highlighted just kind of go like, And what this means is that now all of these elements are movable separately. So even an element as small as this one, see, it even became disattached from the box that it was in, and it can be moved separately. This sentence can be moved separately. This tiny little scribble on this graph right here can also be moved separately. So it really is up to you, but it is something that people, I think, sometimes struggle with when they're first starting to use Explain Everything. They're like, I wanted to move the whole illustration and only a tiny little part of it moved. What do I do? This is what you do. You use the inspector tool and the group and ungroup functions respectively. Okay, So that's that. Say for instance, you are a teacher and you just spent, I don't know, and you just spent a whole bunch of time writing out this part of the equation right here. But you don't want to have to do that every single time that you're teaching the same subject. So once again, you can use the inspector tool. Highlight this element right here. Oops, this element that you're interested in. And then, for example, select add as clip art. And what that does, remember we just talked about clip art a moment ago? What that does is it adds it to your clip art library. So say for instance, let me just move to another part of the project. The canvas is infinite, so I can go wherever I want, as far as I want, forever. So I'm just gonna move to another part of the canvas to show you how this works. Go to add media, then go to clip art. And as you can see, there's the typical clip art stuff that, you know, explain everything user has access to. But then there's also something called custom, and this is your custom clip art library. And notice that that particular part of the equation is now available. So you don't have to redraw or rewrite things every single time. If you created something that you liked, feel free to add it to your clip art library. And then you can reuse it anytime with just a couple of taps instead of taking the time to draw and redraw and re-redraw the same thing over and over again every time you're teaching that specific class or that specific subject. The last thing I think that we have time for is copy and paste, which is also something that's super useful and also something that you can do using the inspector tool. So let's go to that tool again right here. Now we can highlight by dragging, you know, by dragging our finger or our pencil or stylus across the screen, all of the elements we are interested in. Tap copy right here. And then say, for instance, if we opened up a new, fresh project, a brand new, squeaky clean canvas, we could go to the inspector tool and tap paste. And what would happen is all of those elements are now here in a fresh new project. And if you're kind of missing the squares in the background, you know, or the lines, the paper that was used, we could say, in the other project, let me show you how to do that as well. Maybe let me just get rid of this from the canvas real quick. You have to tap here, then tap the little color icon, and then you can tap the texture, so it can be, the pattern. So it can be texture, dots, grid lines, vertical lines, etc., etc. Let's go with grid lines since we're talking about math. We're gonna tap done. And now let's paste that equation one more time. So tap paste, and now our equation, whoops, maybe let's just group this so it moves as one item. And now, as you can see, our equation is on a much more math looking background. And it looks just like a notebook would, except thanks to using an iPad or other, you know, tablet, Chromebook with Explain Everything, what happens is all of your books and all of your notebooks and your digital whiteboard, everything that you need can be in one place instead of having to, you know, to carry a whole bunch of stuff around with you all day, every day, to all of your classes. I hope that I was able to make this a little bit easier for you. I know that getting into a new software can sometimes seem intimidating and a little bit tricky. I hope that I was able to show you how the basic tools work so that you can feel confident using Explain Everything in your lessons. But as I said, this is only the beginning because this is part one of two parts of the beginner, you know, the beginner Explain Everything training. So I would like to take this last couple of moments to invite you to part two, which is in exactly 2 days from now, where I will be showing you how to, you know, record videos and share them with your students, broadcast interactive, colorful, engaging presentations. I'll be showing you how to take all of these different things that we learned about today and basically turn them into shareable creations that your students can work together on with you or that they can even work on by themselves. So with that, I would like to say thank you to everyone who joined. I'm really happy that you found the time, and I'm really hoping that I will see you again on Thursday. So take care, and if you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us, and if not, I will see you in 2 days on Thursday. Okay? Thanks, everybody. Bye.